Jingle bell, 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 bell. I hope you guys are having an amazing day today. Hello. If you hear banging, I live in an old house. My windows aren't secure and they rattle constantly with any wind. Sorry about that. Today's candle of the day is Black Tie from Bath & Body Works, a good old classic. Weirdly, kind of my New Year's scent. Like, I always burn it right after Christmas. This feels like a, I don't know how else to describe it other than a New Year's vibe, but anyway. Today's video I'm super excited about because it is a collaboration with one of my fave channels, and that is Tara Brooke here on YouTube. Tara is actually one of my like OG subscribers. She's been subscribed to me for like a really long time, and I followed her on Twitter, God, it must have been 3 or 4 years ago at this point, right when I was first starting my channel. I followed her on Twitter just because I was like following people that followed me, and I followed her and I found her, and we have like the same opinion on almost everything. And she actually has her channel now that she's doing. She does like beauty stuff, and I've talked about her a couple times in a few other different videos, but I just love Tara's whole vibe. I feel like she's very OG YouTube, like just there for the makeup, talk to you about makeup, and I really, really enjoy that about her. I love her content. So I'll have her link down below. She actually came up with the idea for this tag and then kind of pitched it to me and was like, would you want to do it? And I think it's a really, really fun idea, really fun tag. So I'll have her link down below. Definitely go check her out. And yeah, let's get right into the video. So we are calling this the celebrity slash influencer beauty brand tag. By the way, can I just say, Tara sent me all of this in a Google Doc, and like a woman of my own heart, Google Docs are my life. So the first question is, what are your general thoughts on celebrity influencer beauty brands? Okay. I have mixed opinions. It really depends on the brand. Because here's the thing. I have seen brands like Rare Beauty and Fenty Beauty that are celebrity brands that I feel like they genuinely, maybe the celebrity doesn't care, but the team that is working for that celebrity genuinely cares. Like, they genuinely are trying to put out good products. They're trying to follow trends. They're trying to be innovative. They care about the quality of their products, and they're not just banking on the built-in audience of the celebrity buying from them. And I think that that's awesome. I love a good celebrity brand where it's like they genuinely seem to care. I love that. But then on the flip side of that, you have brands like Kylie and Kim. You have brands like House Labs, which is Lady Gaga's brand, that just feel a little bit more like cash grabs. And maybe, I don't know if House Labs maybe falls into that. I don't know if House Labs is a cash grab so much as I don't think they really care about their quality of product, but I think that's like a purpose. Like, I think they're trying to make a new trend. I don't know. I'll talk about House Labs in a minute, but there's other celebrity brands where it does feel like a cash grab. It feels very much like they're just putting out product to make money and banking on their built-in audience to buy whatever has their name on it. Absolutely. I think as far as influencer brands go, my opinions on this have changed over the years. I feel as if starting an influencer brand is smart. Because it is. It's smart to kind of take your built-in audience and try to create something bigger and use that built-in audience as a springboard to make yourself bigger. It's kind of like what Jeffree Star did. Like, I do think that's smart, and I get why they do it. But I think what is worrying now is just the oversaturation of beauty influencer brands. And I think that that's kind of weird. I think because there are some people doing it just for the cash grab, it makes it harder for the people who genuinely seem to care about their brands. Makes it harder for them to be as successful. And I think because there are some people doing it that like just don't care, it delegitimizes the people who do. Because it's kind of like, say what you will about Jeffree Star and Jeffree Star Cosmetics, it's fairly obvious that he cares and puts a lot of time and energy into that brand. Where when you compare the work that he puts into his brand to like Nikita Dragon and her brand and the work that she's putting into it, which doesn't seem like a whole lot, I think that it can kind of become a little bit difficult. So again, I think it really just depends on the brand. But as a whole, I don't think they're a bad thing. I just think that sometimes they can kind of cross the line into being cash grabs. Okay, the next question is, brands that give off the most cash grab vibes. Okay, definitely Kylie and Kim. But I will say, I think there's other brands too that kind of have float, they're newer ones that are emerging. Like for example, Florence by Mills, which is Millie Bobby Brown's brand. I do low-key think that's kind of a cash grab. And I don't mean this to say that I think the products are bad, because I don't. I think the products are actually pretty good. And I think for who they're marketing to, it's good. But I will say, I don't think that Millie Bobby Brown at like age 15 had this deep burning desire to create amazing innovative makeup for her teenage fan base. Like, I think the reality is because a brand pitched it to her as like, hey, if you put your name on this, a lot of people are going to buy it. And I think they were right because a lot of people have bought it because it's her brand. So I think there's some that are more obvious cash grabs where it's like, well, the quality is not always that great. But I think you can have good quality and still be like the intention behind it is cash grabby. And I think the same thing with influencer brands. I mean, Nikita is an obvious influencer brand that I think is very cash grabby, but more so like these newer ones that are popping out, like the Catherine from the Ace family is coming out with a beauty brand. Okay. I know I saw Emma Chamberlain is now like the brand ambassador for some skincare brand that's like feels so out of left field, frankly. And I think there are some like that I definitely do feel are more cash grabby. I think weirdly, some of the OG influencers that kind of starting makeup brands. So you have like Manny, Laura, Jeffrey, Kristen Dominique, like those brands weirdly feel very authentic and genuine, at least to me. Whereas like other brands that are from these new wave of influencers or just like lifestyle influencers kind of infiltrating to create their own brands, those feel less genuine and more cash grabby to me. Seems like they saw the success that those people had and now they want a piece of the pie as well, you know? The next question is brands that you own the most products from. Definitely Fenty. I own so much from Fenty Beauty. It's kind of bad. I genuinely love their products, so I own a lot from them. They're actually one of my favorite brands just in general. And probably a close second would be Rare Beauty because I bought so much from that first collection. And also now I'm on their PR list, so I get stuff from them. So probably Rare Beauty would be a close second, but Fenty and Rare have been kind of the two standouts for me, especially this year in celebrity brands. As far as influencer brands, who do I own the most of? I own a lot of Kristen Dominique. I own a lot of Lunar Beauty, and I also own a lot of Huda Beauty products. So probably Huda for influencer brands would be the most. And then for celebrity brands, it would be Fenty for sure. The next is brands that you haven't tried, but that you want to. I actually am very, very interested in Victoria Beckham's makeup line. I initially wrote this one off as a cash grab. Like I was like, okay, because the products were really expensive and it just didn't look incredible in pictures. But I've since learned a lot more about her mission and how it's kind of about making sustainable beauty. And she actually has like a ton of input, I guess, and really cares about the quality of product. And the price point is really high, but it's because it's made so ethically. That interests me a lot. I think it's made me really, really intrigued on trying her brand. I just kind of haven't yet because it is kind of expensive, but that's something I would love to try. I've always been kind of interested in her whole message of her brand and kind of what she's doing. I just think it's kind of cool. And then as far as influencer brands, I would say M Cosmetics, which was started by Michelle Phan, kind of the OG beauty guru, Michelle Phan. I would say M Cosmetics is one. I've seen a lot of good things about M Cosmetics. I've seen that they put out good products. Again, it's kind of one that's just flown under the radar for me, but that is definitely a brand from an influencer that I would want to try. This one is brands that you would be more willing to try if its owner wasn't so problematic. Oh God. I actually probably would want to try the, there's a couple. So I actually probably would want to try the Nikita Dragon color correctors if I didn't like just really not want to support Nikita. I actually probably would want to try those color correctors because from videos I've seen, it seems like those color correctors are actually really good. And I have very dark circles around my eyes. And I think it would be cool to try like a good color corrector. That would be awesome. Also with Jaclyn Hill Cosmetics, I cannot support Jaclyn Hill or her cosmetics brand, but the highlighter palettes that she put out actually looked really, really beautiful. And a lot of people that I watch reviews from reviewed it and really, really enjoyed those highlighter palettes. So I will say I wish I could have bought one of those highlighter palettes because it looked really pretty. Also, I think a more obvious one is Jeffree Star Cosmetics, but that's just because when I first started out in makeup, I had a couple of his lipsticks because I didn't know anything about him. I just had heard his products were really good and I had a few of his lipsticks. And to be fair, the lipstick formula is really dope. So I do wish I could buy those lipsticks again because I really liked them. But brands with the most controversial launch. I think for celebrity brands, it was definitely House Labs. Not only because the products they launched were a little bit just like out there, like it was just kind of a weird first launch to have. Not only for that reason, but I think the other reason was because you could only buy it through Amazon. And I just felt like that was a very weird decision to make. Like I felt like, especially given everything that Lady Gaga has kind of said that she stands for and given all of that, having it be for sale only through Amazon instead of its own website was just kind of a weird choice. And again, left a bad taste in my mouth for the brand. Like I didn't want to buy anything through them. With Amazon being such a problematic just corporation, I try to shop from Amazon basically as little as possible. It's really only in like emergency situations that I'll shop from there. So the fact that you could only buy her makeup through a company that I really don't like to support left a weird taste in my mouth. I wasn't a fan of that. And obviously, as far as most controversial, you know, influencer brands, since Jaclyn Cosmetics. I think that's a, she's the winner, winner, chicken dinner on that one. But I will say, I think that Patrick Starr also had, with One Size Beauty, also had kind of a weird launch, just because his very first product was the mist and the makeup wipes. And I think a lot of people just felt like that was kind of a weird move. As a makeup brand, your first product launch is a makeup remover when nobody even has any makeup from you to remove. Like, it was just weird. And then like 2 weeks later, he put out all this makeup and it was like, why was this not just your first launch? Anyway, that was kind of a weird one. But I think to say anything other than Jaclyn Cosmetics as like most controversial launch would be a lie, you know? Next is brands that wouldn't have seen the success it's had if it didn't have a famous face behind it. Definitely Kim and Kylie, 100%. Those lip kits would never have gone anywhere if it didn't have the Kylie Jenner like lips behind them. Similarly with House Labs, if House Labs had just launched as a normal brand, I don't think anybody would have cared. Like, honestly, I don't think anybody would have cared about like eyeliners, and I don't think anybody would have cared. I also think that a brand like Makeup Geek would have struggled to be as successful without having Marlena Stell behind them. Marlena Stell was such a huge influencer at the time when she launched it, and I think having that built-in audience kind of gave her a platform that she needed during that time, because she definitely launched that before the sort of makeup bubble started booming. And I think that it would have been harder for her to stand out in the, you know, growing makeup industry without having her name behind her as like the brand owner and her built-in audience. I also think you could really say for any influencer brands that if they didn't have their name behind it, I don't think it would have been as successful. I think especially in like the beginning, I think there's brands from influencers that could go on to be successful had they had the same trajectory they do now, but I think it would have been 10 times harder without the face. It's kind of why you put celebrities behind brands, you know? The next is brands that don't rely on its owner for success. I think for celebrities, this is Flower Beauty by Drew Barrymore. I see Drew Barrymore talking about this and doing press for this, but I really didn't know that Flower Beauty was associated with Drew Barrymore for a while. I would just see it in Walmart and thought the products were cool. I think what's cool about Flower Beauty is it's not really modeled around like Drew and her aesthetic and her vibe and her whatever. It's really just kind of its own thing. Like, they came up with their own concept, their own kind of vision for the brand and executed it, and Drew just kind of happened to be like the spokesperson for it. And you rarely see like her as like the main focus. I know she's in some of the promo pictures, but if you didn't know that she wasn't the brand owner, it would just look like the same way CoverGirl has celebrities in their promo pictures. Like, that's kind of what it would look like. You never really see Drew like pushing it on social media or anything like that. It kind of is just a brand on its own, and it doesn't really have her constantly promoting it to make it successful. I also think as far as influencer brands, Huda Beauty would kind of be the one that relies the least on the influencer's success. Even though she is kind of definitely the face of Huda Beauty, like obviously it's her name, it's her face, I don't feel like people buy her products because they love her and they're like obsessed with her as an influencer. I feel like people buy her products because they've built up a really, really strong reputation for themselves of being really solid formula-wise, just solid in general. Like, I think the reason that she got so much hype in the beginning was because it was Huda and she had connections with other influencers to like promote her products. But I think over the years, she as a person has kind of stepped back, and I think the brand is much more about its own vibe, its own thing, and doesn't rely on her promotion to do well. Okay, the next question is brands that surprisingly don't align with their owner's persona or aesthetic. I feel like really one of the only examples of this I can think of is Patrick Starr and One Size Beauty. Everything about that brand aesthetic is just so boring to me and like not interesting. Even I have the like spray. It's just so like basic and like red. I felt like his MAC collections, maybe that's why, because I felt like his MAC collections did such a good job of kind of showing his personality through their concepts and through everything. I feel like they did so well at that, that when you have now One Size Beauty, even the naming of One Size Beauty doesn't really feel on brand for Patrick. Like, it's a very weird vibe to the whole brand. It never really feels like him, if that makes sense. So I would have to say One Size Beauty for that one. Yeah, that's probably the biggest one. I think most of these brands though match them. And also Drew Barrymore's Flower Beauty, I guess you could say. I don't feel like that really matches her aesthetic, but I think a lot of these brands really rely on matching the aesthetic of the owner. So it's a little bit different, but One Size for some reason just doesn't feel like Patrick Starr's brand at all. Brands that deserve more hype. I actually think that like Dominique Cosmetics and Lunar Beauty deserve more hype. I know that they're already pretty hyped, but, and again, I know I could be biased about Lunar Beauty because I'm friends with Manny, but like I genuinely genuinely think Manny's products and quality is so good, and I think his concepts are fantastic, and I know that he gets a decent amount of hype, but I feel like he should get more. Like, I feel like his reputation and the way people perceive him as a YouTuber has definitely hurt him and his brand over the years, which sucks because I think that his product's quality and the innovation of the products is really, really good. And it's the same thing with Dominique Cosmetics. I feel like because she's not as massive of an influencer, she doesn't get as much attention to her brand, but her products are so genuinely good. The quality is always amazing and on point. The packaging is always super cute. The concepts are always great. Her color stories of her eyeshadows are super, super unique. And also her lip products are awesome. So I feel like she doesn't get enough credit for her concepts, color stories, and products that she should. I think those are two brands that I think definitely deserve more hype. And then brand that doesn't live up to the hype. You know what's funny is I was actually a part of the hype, but the Kylie Jenner lip kit hype was so undeserved. I was a part of it. I literally thought that those lip kits like saved my life. I thought they made my lips look a million times better. I thought they were the best formula on the planet. The reality is those lip kits didn't deserve the hype. They were incredibly drying. The lip liners kind of suck. Like it wasn't actually that great. And it's the same thing now. Some of her products I think are pretty good, but for the most part, I think her products are really overhyped because it's Kylie. And also she gets these kind of cool concepts that she never fully delivers on, but because the packaging is cool, people go for it. Case in point would be like the Grinch collection. I also low-key think that Jeffree Star Cosmetics gets too much hype. I feel like at one point in time, the hype was deserved. I feel like after Blood Sugar, the hype was deserved. But now I just feel like he puts so much effort into concept and packaging, so that's all cool, but doesn't really put any thought into like color stories. And I think that that makes a lot of his palettes look kind of boring. I also think that because he likes to make his color stories really out there and different, they almost border into randomness to the point where it's like they'd be difficult to use. Just like looking at them, they look like they would be difficult to use because they look so sporadic and random. I think if other brands came out with color stories like that, it would get roasted, but because it's Jeffree Star and he's built up this reputation, people really like it. So I think his brand, especially now in 2020, is way overhyped. I think there was a time when it was deserved, but I think that time has passed. The final question is, who is one celebrity or influencer that you would love to see come out with their own beauty brand in the future? Oh man. One celebrity I would love to see is Taylor Allison Swift. Like my folklore? No. I don't want to start a makeup line. I don't want to spend all my money on it. No, I'm just kidding. No, one person I think would be really good. I actually would love to see Raw Beauty Christie come out with a makeup line, only because her ColourPop collaboration and also her Pure collaboration, I felt like were so well thought out and well put together that I just really was like low-key obsessed with it. Like I wasn't even like the most massive fan of all the color stories, but I just thought the innovation was really cool. Like the fact that she did the double-sided palette for the Pure collab with the colorful side and the neutral side, I thought that was such a genius idea. And the same thing with the ColourPop collaboration, I felt like her color story was really interesting, but not only that, it was inspired by Washington State. Like she drew inspiration from a place that she loved, and I thought that it ended up being such a cool and cohesive collection because of where she drew her inspiration from. So I kind of would love to, I don't know if she ever would do something like that, but it would be, I think Christie like has the brain, like the creative brain to make really, really cool products. As far as celebrities go, it's a little bit harder because I don't really, I think honestly Miley Cyrus would make some like rockin' makeup only because she is like so, again, just so creative in a very different way than Christie, but she's just so creative that I feel like she would make like rock and roll themed makeup. I feel like she could come in and single-handedly turn around Urban Decay, like in their dying brand. Like I feel like she could make an Urban Decay-esque style makeup very, very well. That's very like hardcore, no fucks given, like just doing crazy color stories and crazy packaging and cool concepts. I feel like she would actually do that very, very well. Because again, I think she has that sort of creative brain. I could see like splatter painted makeup with like drawings over it and like all of these neon color stories. Like I could see all of that falling under her brand for sure. Anyway, that is the tag. I tag anyone who wants to do this tag. If you want to do it, tag you're it. You can do this fun little tag. I thought it was cool. I'll leave the questions down below. Go subscribe to Tara. Go check out her channel. Go check out her answers. I'm sure they will be either very similar or very different. So that's where we follow most things. I love you guys so much. I hope you like this this video. If you did, please like and subscribe, or just like, or just subscribe, or do neither. Honestly, just so happy you're watching me. Thank you so much for being here. My merch, including my Glomus merch, my social media, and everything I'm wearing on my face will be linked down below, along with links and information to the Georgia Senate runoff races that are happening on January 5th. Super important. Stay informed, stay involved. I love you guys so much, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!